11 doctors walk into a bar. The first doctor mumbles everything he says, forgets everybody's names, and starts hugging all the young people. He hasn't even started drinking. The second doctor, he sat in the corner all evening blowing his recorder. The third doctor got Terry Walsh to start a barroom brawl for him. The fourth doctor stayed so long he had to get kicked out. The fifth doctor would have been a lot more fun if he got rid of his annoying friends. The sixth doctor showed up but we didn't see him leave. The seventh doctor kept on saying he'd been here before but he doesn't remember when. The eighth doctor showed up for an hour, we didn't see him leave either. The ninth doctor acted like he didn't want to be there. The tenth doctor had to get kicked out because of all the people he snogged. And the eleventh doctor was too young to get in. So, who here's a Doctor Who fan? Come on, make some noise! Yeah, alright, and someone's holding up an R2-D2. Oh, I'm confused! Alright. Now, what I'm gonna need just the modern fans right now. The modern fans, on the count of three, give me a Geronimo. 1, 2, 3! Fans, come on, make me feel even more excited by giving me all my giddy aunt on the count of three. 1, 2, 3.
Oh,
you've giddied my aunt. Now, just the male fans right now. The male fans, okay, I want you to give me a on the count of three. 1, 2, 3. Some people got their hands involved. Excellent work. Good job. Now, just the female fans. Just the female fans. Welcome. Thank you very much for coming. It's a pleasure to see you all here. On behalf of male fandom, we appreciate you, even though we do not understand you. Now, as we all know from Law and Order, the best way to enter a room is with the doink doink sound. Chat myself. Now, this is the first time in my life that I actually took the time to stop and think about all the things that the doctor's responsible for. Okay, because let's be honest, this is my role model, alright? This is what I bought into. I basically bought into a guy who pretty much stole a time machine from his own people, abducted his underage granddaughter, and proceeded to pick up young, impressionable men and women and encouraged them to join him in interfering with people all through time and space. Alright? Some people are cheering? Oh my god! Okay. Now, he then left his granddaughter in a war field. Alright? Now, other companions have been so traumatized they ran away, have been left in the wrong part of England, have had their memories wiped. One, if they even thought of the doctor again, their head would explode. Their head would explode! Some have been left in parallel dimensions with zeppelins in the sky, and some have even died, sacrificing themselves for the doctor. So human beings, with one life, have sacrificed themselves so that the doctor, a man who can pretty much live forever, could live, right? And one fan had to marry Brian Blessed, all right? Oh, look away, children. He may take on other forms. Now, he can't even answer to his crimes for his own people, okay? Why? Because he killed them all at the same time as he killed the Daleks. Now, these two acts of genocide can't be confused with the other acts of genocide he committed in the classic series. Oh yeah, there are different categories to the Doctor's genocide, all right? Oh yeah, now he did actually find one of his own people, eventually. Yeah, the Master. Who killed himself rather than live with the Doctor? Come on! So after hearing all this, who is still a Doctor Who fan? That's where I also met Hayley. Now, Hayley was in the year below me doing the theatre production course, and our courtship was very much like high school still. We passed notes back and forth, friends would pass on messages to each other, pass them back to us, and I didn't really have that much experience, who would have thought. So much so, on our third date, I had Hayley alone in my apartment, and we were doing that awkward talk, giggling, her long pauses, and I got an idea. Turned to Hayley and I said, Hayley, Would you care to join me in watching some Doctor Who? So I chucked on Day of the Daleks, which is a John Pertwee story, which is kind of like Terminator with bad hair. So it's Terminator. But it actually worked out to be a good thing because after about 5 minutes, Haley was so mind-numbingly bored, we were making out. Hooray! So life was good. I had my best friend, I had a girlfriend, and I had Doctor Who. Case in point, a couple of years ago, I was back in Dubbo for the holidays with my family, and I thought I'd pick up a copy of Underbelly Season 1. Yeah, oh yeah. Banned here in Victoria, so I thought I'd pick up a copy. Went up to the counter, dropped it there, and the guy behind the counter went, "Oh, Underbelly. Did you watch what was on TV? It was pretty awesome." And I went, "Yes! I did watch this on television, as I am from New South Wales. Yes, I watched this show completely legally, as all us New South Welshmen are wont to do. Well, what a lovely day it is, sir, here in our premier state. Well, I'll go pick some Waratah. That's right, yes. And I'll watch some of the rugby league while drinking the schooner of the Tui's New. That's legal." So, period four, the last period of the day came around and I just wanted to see out the end of the day until that final bell rang. 5 minutes into my final class, a senior girl barged in, all right? Now, I can't use her name for legal reasons, so I'll just call her Bitchy McFlameFlame. Now, Bitchy McFlameFlame barged into my class and started verbally assaulting one of my students, one of my female students, all right? And I went up trying to calm her down, but get her out because it was inappropriate, and Bitchy McFlameFlame just went on, just swearing, calling her awful names until this girl in my class was a puddle of tears on the floor. And Bitchy McFlameFlame ignored me completely. She left when she was ready, and she walked out as if she owned the school, not even paying attention to me. I snapped. I went after Bitchy McFlameFlame and I screamed. Not yelled, screamed at her. I have never screamed that loud at anyone in my life. I used words like dishonor, no respect. I didn't even use the cliche, "I'm not angry, I'm disappointed," because I was fucking angry. I went on and on at her until she burst into tears. She apologized profusely. She was terrified. I'll pass this on to the Department of Education. All right, okay. And we'll give the PE teachers Uzis. Excellent. Sure, Bitchy McFlameFlame was scared, but I was scared too. I was terrified. I said to myself, "I can't do this. I'm not coping. I've got to go. I know I'm contracted for 6 months, but I've got to leave. I've got to get the hell out of here, all right?" But then I thought to myself, what would the doctor do? The doctor would run away, the doctor would not be a coward, he would stay and fight, all right? And I felt like the doctor. I was a stranger in a strange land, all right? I didn't know how to communicate with the natives. "Yeah, what's up, G? I don't know, I'm a nerd, I think velvet's a good idea, come on!" All right, I was the doctor in a strange land, so I did what the doctor would do. I talked to people, and I listened. I listened to the students and I listened to the senior teachers and I found out how they survived. Now, I'm not saying I was a great teacher, I'm not even saying I was a good teacher, but I did what I had to survive. And I set myself one golden rule: never let the bastards make me cry. Never let it get so bad that they make me cry. All right? So, as I was a doctor in this strange land, I started to find and identify strays. And they were kind of like me, because they were me when I was in high school. I found drama nerds. And I needed somewhere safe to go, so I brought them to my drama room, which was kind of like my TARDIS, because it was built right next to the gymnasium. It was a low roof as you open up the front door, and as you walked in, it opened up into this huge, open, cathedral-like space.
Bigger on the inside!
My drama room was bigger on the inside than it was on the outside. Doctor, my students were my companions, and the TARDIS was my drama room. And the adventures through time and space we went on were the productions we did. Okay? We went back to 1960s Italy, dealing with police corruption in Ashland, Death and Atticus. We went back to the sweltering heat of 1950s New York in 12 Angry Men. We went to 1970s Melbourne in an insane asylum dealing with the Vietnam protests in Cozzy. All right? And at the end of my... Twat. Now, at the end of my 4.5 years at this school, I decided I had to step away from my backup and go back to my main love, performing. And on my last day, the kids got me a gift. And they made me break my golden rule.
Aww. Aww.
Bastards made me cry.
Ladies and gentlemen, presenting his stirring tribute to the 11 incarnations of the Doctor, Robert Lloyd will now present the premiere of his movement piece, Elf Guten Manner. Ladies and gentlemen, Robert Lloyd.
Thank you for coming this evening. It's indeed a pleasure to have you here with this truly special event. I'm incredibly proud of this piece. It's been long, really. But here, at the end, I can honestly say, it's been worth it. Enjoy.